Hello, this is Ron Paul with your weekly update for Monday, November 3rd. Last week's tragic shootings in Canada and Washington State are certain to lead to new calls for gun control. The media-generated fear over lone wolf terrorists will enable the gun control lobby to smear Second Amendment supporters as pro-terrorists. Marketing gun control as an anti-terrorist measure will also enable gun control supporters to ally with those who support any infringement on liberty done in the name of homeland security. As with most infringement on liberty, gun control will not only make us less free, it will make us less safe. Respecting the right of the people to keep and bear arms is the original and best homeland security policy. Restricting the right of people to arm themselves leaves them with no effective defense against violent criminals or a tyrannical government. Every year, thousands of Americans use firearms to stop violent criminals. One notable example occurred in September when Oklahoman Mark Vaughn used a rifle to stop a knife-wielding co-worker who had already killed one person and wounded another. Unfortunately, most of the media coverage focused on speculation that the assailant was motivated by radical Islam rather than on Vaughn's use of a firearm to protect innocent lives. It is no coincidence that states that pass concealed carry laws experience a drop in crime. Since passing concealed carry in Texas in 1995, murder in the state has declined by 52%. In comparison, the national murder rate declined by only 33%. Perhaps the best illustration of the dangers of gun control is the federal regulations forbidding pilots from having guns in their cockpit. Ironically, this rule went into effect shortly before September 11, 2001. If pilots had had the ability to carry guns on 9/11, the hijackers may well have been stopped from attacking the World Trade Center and Pentagon or persuaded not to even try. Shortly after 9/11, I introduced legislation allowing pilots to carry firearms in the cockpits. Congress eventually passed a bill allowing pilots to carry firearms if they obtained federal certification and obey federal regulation. Aside from the philosophical objection that no one should have to ask government permission before exercising a right, the rules and expensive approval process discourage many pilots from participating in the Armed Pilots Program. It should not be surprising that the anti-gun Obama administration wants to eliminate the Armed Pilots Program. I actually agree that the program should be eliminated so long as pilots who can legally carry a firearm in their states of residence can carry a firearm on the planes they fly. Allowing pilots to carry guns is certainly a more effective way of protecting our security than forcing all airline passengers to endure the TSA. Both gun control and foreign interventionism disregard the wisdom of the country's founders. An interventionist foreign policy like gun control threatens our safety. A hyper-interventionist foreign policy invites blowback from those who resent our government meddling in their countries while gun control leaves the people defenseless against violent criminals. Returning to a foreign policy of peace and free trade and repealing all federal infringements on the Second Amendment will help guarantee both liberty and security. Thanks for calling this update. A new update is placed on this number, 888-322-1414, every Sunday. The written text can be found on my Ron Paul Institute website at ronpaulinstitute.org and on my Facebook page. Thanks for calling.